everyone.
And look at
it's our tita's birthday.
And look, and look at her tongue. But I see that tita
So, kakatapos lang namin mag-breakfast. Kumain kami ng dragon food. Yeah. So, it's Violet. Kakain lang namin ng dragon fruit. That was our breakfast. No? So, ito siya. We got dragon fruit from our farm. Here, there. So, alam nyo ba kung saan galing ang dragon fruit? No? It's from a cactus family. No? Plant siya na mukha rin siyang cactus. Kung gusto nyo malaman kung paano magtanim ng dragon fruit, saan nanggagaling ang dragon fruit, anong itsura ng halaman, no? Watch this, okay?
Watch this!
Watch this! Bye! Bye! Say bye!
Watch this! Don't forget watch to this. Subscribe
to like our next video.
Watch this, you click. Watch this!
Life Adventures.
Hello everyone, good afternoon. This is Doc Ron. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to teach you about a very special fruit. This is very common here now in Palawan. No, although it's very expensive, it will cost you around 200 to 300 pesos per kilo. So I'm starting to grow this plant because I know this one has a lot of vitamins and minerals. They said that this one is good for diabetes and hypertension. So welcome to my farm. This is my dragon fruit plantation with some extra Hawaiian pineapple in between, but I'm going to teach you and show you about this special fruit. It is known as pitaya, no? Although popularly known in our place here in Palawan and in the Philippines as dragon fruit, kasi mukhang dragon daw yung skin niya, no? So I have a lot of ripe fruit already here. So this one is a 3-year-old plant. No, it's part of a cactus family. No, although hindi siya sa desert, lumalaki or dumadami, pero doon sa nutritious na loam soil. No, hindi rin siya pwede sa masyadong matubig na area, dapat dry. So this is the dragon fruit plant, no? As you can see, it's like a cactus, no? So meron akong stand. So this is the fruit. Ay. See? This is the fruit flower. Ito dito, may flower dito. So ito yung flower niya. This one is the flower. It's self-pollinating. Self-pollinating meaning yung pollens niya kailangan lang ipasok dun sa loob para mag-develop siya into a fruit. Kasi kung hindi, no? Pag hindi siya na-pollinate, hindi siya ma-develop ng dragon fruit. So normally the ones who are helping pollinate this flower is the insects, the bees, no, the butterflies, etc. And papasok siya. This one only blooms no once in its lifetime yung flower. So normally nagbo-bloom to, matsatsambahan mo siya sa gabi. No, normally at around 1 to 3 a.m. No? Pag bumulaklak to, it is considered one of the biggest flower kasi malaki yung diameter niya. So malaki yung flower niya and doon siya pwedeng mag self-pollinate, no? Okay? So pero may ibang pamamaraan na pag nag-bloom siya, what other people do is they use a stick and then steer the center of this flower, no, para mag self-pollinate siya without the insects, the help of the insects, no. So ganun siya. Pag hindi, especially kapag hindi siya nag self-pollinate tapos naulanan siya, hindi magde-develop yung fruit. In other places, no, especially in Thailand, where dragon fruit is also popular, pag rainy season, tinatalian nila ng rubber band tong center. No, tinatalian nila para hindi ma-damage ng ulan. Okay? Very hot. So, how do you grow this one? No, so normally you just get one stem, one stalk, no? Ito. No? Itong joint dito. Okay, this one. Okay? You can cut it here. Putulin mo yan dito. And then stick this on the ground. Ganun lang kadali. No? Puputulin to. So this one. Okay, for example, you cut this. Here. You cut this. And then you plant it on the ground. Stick it on the ground. Make sure that it's not soaked. Kasi mamamatay yung plant. And most of the time naninilaw siya. So what you do? So these are the samples of the dragon fruit that we gathered. Halika, dito. Yung iba
overripe.
Na overripe na kasi sabi ko hintayin ako eh. No? Sabi ko hintayin ako before nila i-harvest para makita ko siya in actual. So this one is George, my ever so helpful agriculturist. So kung may kailangan kayong assistance, si George Lorzano, one of the best agriculturist in Palawan.
Yes!
No? So ito yung mga fruit niya. No, so we are gathering it. Yung iba na sobra na ng hinog. Back to the basic. So this one, you just plant the matured stalk. Now you plant this on the ground. Demo. Okay. Yan. Okay? So ganun lang. So normally in one post we put at least three stalks like that on each corner. Tapos make sure that your post is sturdy or strong. Kasi pag nasira siya or nabulok yung post mo, malalaglag yung ano mo, yung dragon fruit mo. So what we did was to do cemented post, no? Ito. It's a 4x6 no size na post. You can actually make it bigger, 6x6. Aray ko. Sakit. Maraming tinik. So, tapos naglalagay kami ng old tire na cut para maka-branch out siya sa taas. Okay, so yan yung mga ibang tips. So, make sure that hindi sila nag-iipon sa ilalim. Okay? So, make sure that everything is dried. You make it a little bit inclined. No? Hindi yung patag or malalim kung saan nag-iipon yung water. So, most of the time, slope para the water will slide down naturally. No, hindi siya maiipon na ng water. So, that's how you grow a dragon fruit. We put fertilizer here once every 6 months, no? So yun lang, tapos pabayaan mo lang siya. Make sure that your plant is always clean around, no? Nadamuhan siya, nalinisan siya, para lahat ng nutrition will go to the plant. So this one is an example of a very healthy plant, no? Mataba siya, tapos matigas, hindi yung yellowish yung color, no? Tapos butas. So yan, that is how you grow dragon fruit. Now I encourage everyone to plant, kasi hindi siya mahirap alagaan. Actually, people sometimes use this as a decoration sa mga houses nila, no, sa mga bahay nila, saka sa mga bakod, no, sa fences, no, ginagawa nila tong decoration. No, you can use them. Pero ang maganda nito, it bears fruit. Ang lalaki ng fruit, sometimes dalawang piraso, no, na fruit ay 1 kilo na agad, no? So ganun siya kalaki. And maraming benefit to, like what I've said, it is rich in vitamins and minerals, no? So maraming benefit po to yung dragon fruit. Ginagawa nga nila tong ice cream, candies, no? Yung iba, even the flesh or yung balat niya, yung covering niya, ginagamit nila for other products, no? So maganda siyang i-grow. I encourage everyone to plant, no, the dragon fruit. Kung meron kayong farm na maganda yung lupa, you can get even a small piece of the stalk and then just plant it. It will multiply. For example, like this one, no, you can see that marami na siyang branches, no, marami na siyang branch, okay? And normally on this month, mga June, July, August, yan yung fruiting time, fruiting month of the dragon fruit, no? So ngayon it's the harvest time. So this one is a unripe dragon fruit. Ito po yung itsura niya. Ito po yung pa-develop na na dragon fruit. Ito yung flower niya, no? So ganun, no? Any questions? I hope you learned something from planting a dragon fruit. I just started this 3 years ago. So mapapansin niyo po, marami na akong mga tanim, ang dami ng branches, no, ang dami niya ng branch. So every year mas dumadami po yung fruits niya. Like normally within a span of 2 years, no, magsa-start na po yan siyang mag-bear fruit. Some say na within 11 months or 1 year, 12 months meron na. Pero yung from my experience, 2 years at least na nag-start po silang mag-bear ng fruit. Pero this year, on their 3rd year, mas marami na po yung bunga nila. Okay? In one stalk, you can actually have 2 or more na fruits. Okay? So if you have any questions or you have any comments, don't forget to comment on the comment section. Please subscribe to my channel, no? Subscribe, and I'm sure you're going to learn a lot more in farming and growing fruits. Next time I'll show you how to plant pineapple. So this is the sample of our dragon fruit, no? Buksan natin. There. So yan siya. Okay? So ito yung fruit, no? Madali siyang tanggalin kasi pwede siyang i-peel off, no? Yan, sumasama lang siya, oh. Okay? Sabi nila ang lasa daw nito ay parang kiwi. No, dahil doon sa seeds. So these are the seeds of the fruit. No, you can actually gather them and then plant it. Pero mas madaling i-plant yung stalk. No? So you can just peel it off, no? Tapos ang lasa nito ay parang kiwi din. Tamis. Tamis. Parang sing tamis ni Willy to. Si Willy may cameraman. Si tamis ni Willy. Sabi ni Ma'am Lan. Hmm? So if you want to order, you can order it from me. Namura lang po. 100 pesos. Nag-commerce. Biro lang. So that's it, no? So I hope you learned something, no? If you have a little piece of land, try to plant any number of dragon fruits, no? And I'm sure you won't regret it. Madali siyang alagaan. Masarap yung fruit niya, and you will definitely enjoy it. One of my oldest dragon fruit. As you can see, ang dami. Lapit ka dito, wait. Ang dami ng bunga niya, no? So ito mga bunga niya. This one. This one. See? In one stalk, you have 2 fruit. No, ito pa. Ito, wait. Okay? So, you have 2 fruits here. Meron pang kambal. Ito. Kambal. Kambal. Ito, ang kambal, oh, dalawa. Okay? See? Here? So, tad-tad siya ng bunga. So, if you grow a dragon fruit, you will definitely benefit from the fruits. No, ang dami niyang bunga, lalo na kapag naalagaan. Here's another one. Example here, oh. See? You have 2, 3. 3 fruits already here. Okay? Medyo hindi siya halata kasi green. But if you look closely, see? These are the ones to be harvested in the next few months, no, few weeks. Okay? So, ang daming, and definitely you will enjoy from the fruit, no? Mag-i-enjoy ka pag, lalo na pag maraming-marami, ang sarap siya tingnan. Okay? So, there you have it. Those are my dragon fruits. I hope you enjoy. Thank you. Bye.